I will read at due course, but I thought what I'd do first is just talk about why Helen and what I was thinking when I started. Really, when I've been writing about Hindi cinema forever. I loved it. I enjoyed it. I know it's patriarchal. I know it's mainstream. I know that 98% of what is called Bollywood is actually crap. It's really B-grade trash made with on the fly. But it's also a very important, valid form of cultural expression. It's a form of cultural expression, for instance, that has resisted very strongly the killer instinct of Hollywood. And Hollywood has gone across the world killing cinemas, just as English has gone across the world killing languages. And yet India sort of resisted that. And we resisted that by creating stories and ways of telling stories which were indigenous to us. So when we talk about the melodrama of Hollywood, of Bollywood, for instance, we often ignore the fact that we often lead very clearly melodramatic lives. So I remember talking to Anurag Kashyap after Satya came out and, you know, saying, do gangsters actually talk like this? Are there like this whole entire code of languages and words and secrets that happen there? And he said, if there isn't, then there will be now. You know, but actually that is not entirely untrue. How does one model oneself on what one is going to be? In early cinema, in the 70s cinema, which I saw when I was growing up, it was aspirational models that were being presented to us. You know, when someone went abroad in a film, they actually guided you visually through the entire process so that you saw the person getting down at the airport, getting a trolley, getting into line, going into the film, into the thing, sitting down. It was almost like an instructional video. And so when I wrote my book, Leela, The Life and Times of an H-Bomb, one of the first films that she ever made, Leela made, was a film about using the toilet on an aeroplane. J.R.D. Tata was flying these flights between Delhi and London, and Bombay and London, and many of the people who were traveling on those planes were actually immigrant workers who were used to shitting in the fields, just to put bluntly. So in the morning of a late night flight, when suddenly they were attacked by the desire, they'd go back to the back of the plane if there were empty places and shit on the floor. And then they would take the magazines or newspapers or whatever was hanging around and throw them on top of that. So Leela's first film that she ever made, and it was made with Zafar Hai and with other people, was an instructional video on how to use a toilet on a film, on a plane. So in a stroke of genius, I thought, she actually used a little girl. Because a little girl is allowed to learn. Children are allowed to learn. Adults may not learn. Adults would like to feel that they do not need instruction, which is why the intelligent and the worldly wise traveler never watches the safety instructions on the flight. Because we've seen it all. We know how to open our seatbelt. We know how to close our seatbelt. And of course, we know where the exit windows are. If you're a neurotic traveler like I am, you watch. I do watch them each time, partly for the amusement of it, also because it's rather funny and rather sweet. I like those little gestures. And farsh pe lagi batti aapko nikattam dwar tak pahunchane mein madad karegi. Farsh pe lagi battiyan nikattam. Like, who writes those lines and from which language? Farsh is Persian. Nikattam is Sanskrit. Stick with one boli, chaps. But this leads me to an important and I think interesting thing about Bollywood is that it's a bottom feeder. And the bottom feeder meant that it would take what was easiest and most convenient and it would create out of what was most convenient what was needed. And here, in 1950, after the World War had happened and Burma had been attacked by Hitler. In my family, when Burma was attacked, it was always attacked by Hitler because he was the bad boy. Saying that the Japanese came and attacked seemed like such a wussy thing. But the Japanese attacked Rangoon. My grandfather walked from Rangoon right up to Assam through the jungle, 9 months long, faced malaria, faced tigers, faced hostile people. The giant man who was with him ate earthworms with him in the middle of the jungle. It's the story of a walk that has not been told, and like so many stories in India, it's been under-narrativized. Part of those people walking was a little girl called Helen, who was 9 years old. Later, she would say that her legs were beautiful and strong throughout her life because of that early walking. She walked with her mother, Marlene, who doesn't seem to have been a very, how shall one put it, maternal sort of mother. Marlene, but you have to give her, I mean, Marlene was Anglo-Burmese. Her father was British. Her mother was Burmese. She claimed, Helen claimed later, and a little bit of myth-making, I think, for Filmfare, that there was a bit of Spanish pirate thrown in her ancestry somewhere. But we can take that for, you know. But she was, Marlene's husband was French. He died, and she married a white man, Richardson. So Helen's real name is Helen Richardson.